So when we left off, I believe you guys were headed to do some shopping, yes?
Yes.
Right.
All right. So how did you want to go about that?
Were you wanting to go to the game store, or do you want to just go to like a nearby shop?
I thought we were going to go to their... I thought they had an armor that we could buy stuff from.
Oh, yeah, they do, but I just remember now. I think what we were going to do was we were just going to kind of just check around, see what the best prices are. And also, I think my character kind of needs armor and stuff. Or just something close to it. Clothes. He can't go running around in a loincloth all the time.
Okay, are we still at the Twice-Born Star? Is that where we are now?
Yes.
Okay, and is there armor here at this place?
There are some armor and weapons. They were going to provide you with a camera in order to collect evidence, but I think that was all they were going to provide. The rest you would have to pay for at a 10% discount.
Okay, who's Akela Brand News?
Is that Akela Brands? Yeah, that's the armor that they're sending you to.
Okay, so that person is not here. That person is somewhere else. That's what I'm trying to find out. Where is that person?
He's here, but he's in a different part of the bar.
Okay, is he at a shop? Can I go there and buy other things? That's what I'm getting at. I want to go do that.
Yeah. Yeah, so it doesn't take you very long to locate him. There's sort of, you kind of explore the area, and their main area of the Twice-Born Star is a large kind of bar, cafe, all-in-one kind of thing. But along this, the ring that you see here, along this ring on the outsides are different little shops and vendors, and one of them you come across, it looks to be a weapons vendor, and you guess that this is the one you're looking for.
Are we supposed to be seeing... Oh, never mind, there it is. Okay, I want to go see what this guy's got to say, and then Gamer, if you want to go somewhere else and shop, we can do that afterwards, but we're already here right now, so let's get this place out of the way.
Alright, you want to talk that in roleplay?
Yeah.
Alright, ready when you are.
Okay, so we walk up to this, the shop? There's like a counter or something?
Yes.
Okay, I walk up and I talk to the guy and I say, we're here to pick up some cameras and recording equipment.
The Togruta, who's currently kneeling down underneath, looking underneath some of the counter that he's got in his shop. It's fairly cluttered, but it's a part of the sales counter where you walk up to straight up. Is clear, so business can be done and whatnot. He looks up. Oh, great to see you today.
Good to see you.
What can I help you with today? my merchandise scales are entails everything you see here and a few things I have in the back.
Okay. Well, we need a couple cameras.
All right. Did you tell him that Everin had sent you?
No. Everin sent us.
After he went to bend down to try to find some cameras, and he hears that you said Everin sent him, and he goes, "Oh, that job. Okay." And he changes where he was reaching for and goes and gets what's required, and it's a standard camera, or it looks like a standard camera, but it's fairly nice looking at the same time.
We're only getting one.
No, he's pulled out like a couple of them. It's okay, just that one of them. They all look really shiny. It's just I was describing one.
Okay, so do we each get one? So we can all take photographs or whatever.
Yeah, he'll give you three cameras.
Three. Okay, so one of us doesn't get one.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have any electro binoculars?
That I do. And he points over to his left, your right, and up on the wall there's several binoculars on displays of varying qualities and whatnot. You may make your selection.
Out of character, are there actually different kinds?
No, not just cosmetically different.
Yeah, that's what I mean. It's just cosmetically different. Some are in, obviously, the discount ones that, you know, they've been used by military and whatnot, and have been found on the battlefield. So they're kind of not necessarily in the best shape, and they range from there to pristine.
Okay, so the point is, are some cheaper than others, but are not going to work as well?
Yeah.
Also out of character, I just noticed, can I move back to the top on the condition track, or am I still stuck at -1?
Where were you at -1? Do you remember?
Because I took a hit that was over my damage threshold two sessions ago.
Right. I think we were gonna leave it in there until you guys had a full rest.
Okay. How much for the standard electro binoculars?
Once I find the actual item on the table list. Alright, my standard price for them is about 1,000 credits. But for you, since you're working with Everin, we'll go ahead and give you a 10% discount. so it will be about 900 credits.
May I examine them?
Oh, that you may, that you may. And he pulls whichever one you point at down.
Do you hand it to me? Or
yes.
Set it on the counter or something?
Yeah, he
okay.
Sets it on the counter in front of you, offering for you to examine it and whatnot.
Okay, I carefully pick them up and look at them in my hands and hold them up to my eyes and test them and kind of look through them and adjust the controls.
From everything you can tell, these things are working perfectly.
Just because I have the page open, I want to give you the book description of these. So, this device magnifies distant objects in most lighting conditions. It has an internal display which provides data on range, relative, and true distance and elevation. Also, they feature the more expensive ones tend to feature radiation sensors and a night vision mode that grants dark vision out of the user's normal range of sight. Mechanically, it essentially gives you some bonuses in long distance perception, and it will also, if you purchase ones that have some of the fancier outlets, it'll let you see things in the dark and also potentially see radiation.
That word is pronounced azimuths. It's similar, it has similar meaning to the word bearing.
I just didn't want to botch it, so I skipped over it. But thank you.
It's like the degrees on a compass.
Alright, that makes sense.
These are very nice electrobinoculars.
Oh, thank you, thank you.
Gekorash taps Walt's shoulder and he whispers in his ear,
can you see if maybe they have any armor around here?
Out of character, Gamer, I'm sorry, I'm having a little bit difficult time hearing you sound kind of quiet.
Should I just skip whispering and just say it aloud, even though he's supposed to be whispering?
I'll just say I whisper this, and then I'll just listen
to all right. Your whispering. Yeah. Hold on, let me turn off the music, because I think that's kind of hindering audio. Yeah,
stage whispering.
Yeah.
Alrighty. So, he whispers,
hey, can you see if they have any armor around here?
Sure, buddy. We'll get to that. No problem. Don't worry about it.
Pats his shoulder, hinting to thanks.
I mean, you can just look to see, while I'm examining these electrobinoculars, you can just look to see if you see any armor on display for sale, or you can talk to the guy too.
Alright.
He kind of walks around, looking around the shop. Out of character. What are they selling any armor? Can you maybe describe like visuals? If you have any pictures, that'd be even better. Just whatever.
Okay. His armors are on display, almost right in front of the counter, and they're set up on the side in a varying display, showing which ones they have.
So they have most of the armor from Knights of the Republic book and the Core Rule book. There are, as far as the energy shields, if that becomes a question, they have a few of them, but not all of the ones that are listed.
I see. Well, I just wondered because just like, I just realized now, are any of them going to fit him? I think they probably won't. Due to his enormous size.
They will fit. We don't. I don't. We just assume that everything fits.
Alrighty. Extra, extra large size. Perfect.
Yeah. Akela will make sure that he takes care of all of his customers with custom fittings, so no worries.
Ah, nice. Are there any, like, visual stuff you could maybe send a link to? Because I'm just trying to get an idea as to all this.
Well, you should probably focus on the stats, and then once you select something, we'll send you a thing. The other thing is, it's all, that's cosmetic. It could be whatever you want it to look like.
Oh, wow. Alrighty.
Yep.
Well, I just kind of want it to stay true to the story.
Yeah, like I said, if you really do, I will send you a link once you select your armor.
Yeah, sure. That'd be cool. Make it really unique. Alrighty, so I'm looking around, and, okay, so you said there's some armor displayed and stuff. I don't know how to say this, like, what stuff do I see and whatnot?
Well, for, on the farthest end, away from the counter is the cheaper stuff. It's, like a blast helmet and vest.
Ah, I see. Is there anything like likened unto clothing or something? Like pants and shirt or something?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Sorry, like maybe a little more advanced than like more like an armor, but just something around that. I mean, it's getting kind of tiring to have him running around in a loincloth, and plus it makes him really weak.
Okay. Yeah, so far, what you can tell, it seems to be a blast helmet vest.
And that's all that's available at the moment.
For what you're asking for, yeah.
Alrighty. So he kind of just examines it and kind of just...
Yeah, there's...
Around. There's nothing really to do for him, personally.
Okay, yeah, there's a lot of actual armor itself. There's, like, the blast helmet and vest, and there's a flight suit, a padded flight suit, and then a couple other things, but that seems to be about it. Nothing...
Oh, wait, you said a flight suit? Wouldn't that cover the whole body?
Yeah.
You didn't tell me that.
That's because breeches are usually come with most armor anyways. It's just that's more of a cosmetic thing, so.
Well, you were asking.
You told me.
Well, you were asking for a t-shirt kind of thing. That's what he was trying to tell you. That's what the blast helmet does. Are you looking at the armor table?
No. We lost TeamSpeak, so I don't have the thing anymore.
Okay, well, so let me just give you the mechanicals. There are several tiers of armor. What are you specialized in? Light armor?
I'm not sure. What are the Jedi specialize in?
Let me just look.
I kind of have a feeling it will be light armor.
You're not specialized in any armor, so that means you have to wear light armor, or you start taking penalties. So, the cheapest armor is the blast helmet and vest. It gives you a reflex defense of +2, and no fortitude defense, and a max dex bonus of 5. So, you're level 2 right now?
Yes.
So this won't help you at all. This won't give you any buffs. The only one that will start to buff you is the next one, which is 2,000 credits. The padded flight suit.
All right,
did you say that we're not counting a armor penalty for light armor if you're untrained with it?
Yes.
Because I have been so far up to this point. I've been putting a minus two.
Oh, you have?
Yeah, am I not supposed to be doing that?
No, I didn't specify it. You are supposed to do that. I just... Because this is just a beginning game, I was just going to let you guys have some light armor. The thing about the armor, it's broken. And I just haven't gotten around to fixing it. It really doesn't do that much for you, to be honest.
Well, that's why I'm asking this, because I bought armor, but I realized that it's not providing me any benefit, and it's actually going to hurt me when I start trying to do stealth checks, so I was just going to get rid of it.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow. So the armor isn't acting like actual armor, it's just cosmetic?
It acts like armor, but I don't know why this game system does it the way it is. It's just broken. Really, the only armor that's useful are the energy shields.
Ouch.
Because they will actually absorb, I think, some of your some hits. Give you a resistance to damage.
Basically, for the most part, what armor does is it increases your reflex defense, which means that the bad guys that shoot at you have to roll higher to be able to hit you. But for most of the, especially the light armor, by the time you get to like level 4 or 5, you can just use your character level as a bonus to your reflex defense instead, and it's better because it's less weight and encumbrance, and you get the same benefit from it. It's pretty weird.
Yeah, because it doesn't add to your character level, it replaces it, which is why it's broken.
Oh, weird. So it's kind of pointless for me to get armor then?
There's the only reasons to wear it is if it confers some additional benefit, like being able to survive in a vacuum of space, or something like, or get like a bonus to, like an equipment bonus of some kind. Or the other reason is just for roleplay purposes. If you just, I mean, your character wears armor because that's his thing. Like, if he's a Mandalorian, it doesn't make sense to have a Mandalorian guy with no Mandalorian armor.
I see.
Yep.
But, yeah, I just wondered, would it probably be best that I do that? Because right now he's pretty much got nothing except something equivalent to underwear, more or less.
I mean, if you would like to buy clothes, you can, that are just purely cosmetic. That's fine. The other thing you can buy are energy shields, because they don't put any penalties on you. They just provide a damage reduction bonus. So, like, a damage reduction bonus of 5 means that once you take a hit, 5 points of that damage is absorbed into the shield.
I see. Does he sell any clothing? Or just armor and weapons and stuff like that.
It's a fairly big or fairly decent all-purpose store. There's armor, there's clothing. He's got. It's almost like Walmart, shall we say?
Okay. All right. What clothes could my character get? Maybe I was thinking maybe a robe would be kind of cool, but that kind of sounds a little weird. I don't know.
Might make you fit in with the cultist we're fixing to go visit.
For the clothing section, you see before you various fashions and trends and whatnot that are going around in the planet and such. There's spacefarer gear, there's robes, there's decorative clothing and whatnot that make you look really nice, and then there's not so decorative stuff that's more for everyday wear kind of things.
Yeah, I wish I had some pictures for these, because I'd kind of choose out of apparel.
Well, the thing is, they don't confer any bonus, so imagine that they look like whatever you want.
Yeah, this is, it's literally like walking into the clothing section of Walmart. It's literally whatever you want is there, pretty much.
Not everything at Walmart, but... Alright, I don't know, because what I'm thinking on is more on the lines of armor, like, literally. I don't know how to describe it better. But just, hold on, let me show you something. This was kind of an idea for, when I do, like, when I level up higher, like, later on in the story. Hold on a second.
Okay, while he's doing that, Barry, I'm going to ask your shopkeeper, I'm going to say, well, these are really exceptional electro binoculars. Would you consider accepting 850 credits for them?
Something kind of like this, but obviously like a brighter gold. And he'd have covering on his arms too. But yeah, just something on the lines of that.
Yeah, John, go ahead and roll persuasion.
Okay. Persuade. Crudler.
He looks at it and looks at you, kind of peering, kind of with that, you know, that bartering look, and goes, well, how about 870?
I consider for a moment, I say, well, it is quality goods, you got a deal.
Excellent, excellent, excellent.
Okay, so just curious, if the stuff I'm wanting has kind of an armorish appearance, would that designate it under armor?
Technically no, because if you want it to look like armor, it doesn't necessarily have to be armor. That's the thing, the picture you linked could easily be very much so a cosmetic or a non-practical armor look.
Ah, I see. Well, I'm just trying to think this realistically, you know.
To be honest, the rules in this aren't set up for realism.
Yeah. If you want your armor to look like that, he can... there are ways of making fabric do that, and in particularly... like certain kind of hard plastics and fabric style plastics, silicones, that can do that.
Oh, no. I want this to be like metal, like actual armor.
Here's the thing we're trying to get you to understand, gamer. You can do that, and you can spend 15,000 credits on a really extravagant suit of armor like that, but it's because of the rules of the game, it's not going to do you any good.
Pretty much, yeah. Armor suit like that would probably be about 15,000 credits.
Well, at least it's like actual armor, that's all I'm saying.
Yeah.
Well, if you want to do it from a role-playing standpoint, then that's fine. But, I mean, you don't have training in wearing that kind of armor, and it's not going to... I mean, it's you're not going to be able to take the reflex defense bonus from it.
No, this is for later. Yeah, this is for later, so yeah, for now I think I'm kind of looking into like Star Wars clothing they have.
It can literally be whatever you want. If you want some robes, they will have robes in what you want. We're talking about appearance right now.
So basically she's saying you can have something that looks like that picture, but isn't actually armor.
Game
mechanically.
I mean, this is, if you want it to look like this, you are going to have to wait. You are correct. That will have to be a later thing. What do you want right now? Do you want some black robes? They've got black robes. Do you want brown ones, more Jedi looking? They got those. Do you want t-shirt and pants? They have those there too. What do you want right now?
Well, I think what I'm going to do is kind of more like a, I don't know. I'm trying to think. Kind of like maybe a bit of a robish appearance. But do they have anything that's maybe a little ornate? Like kind of maybe some gold trim or something like that a little bit?
There are robes like that. They have some have some golden trim and are red colored. Others have are more of a bluish color with a little bit of a greenish trim around the collar area, but those will be a little more expensive than the plain robes.
I think I like the sound of the red one with the gold trim. Yeah, let me try. I'm trying to see something that I could compare to what I'm trying to picture here. Hold on.
Say, shopkeep, I'm also interested in selling this combat jumpsuit that I'm wearing. But obviously I'll need to change out of it into some normal street clothes.
He nods.
Let's see, I'll take those trousers, that shirt, that jacket, and those boots.
All right.
Yeah, like the lower garments that he's wearing, how it kind of sticks out the front, sort of like that. But maybe a little more of an elaborate pattern, maybe like a kind of a different trim to it. But yeah, something like that almost, how it kind of comes out in the front, you know what I mean?
What a coincidence, I see that exact garment hanging right over there that you just described in the corner.
Indeed it is. It's hanging on a metal hanger, and it looks kind of like an ornate scarf, kind of a helmet or chest plate, and it's just kind of hanging.
Oh, nice! Oh, I wish I could have like an actual picture of this. This is I like to think of things in literal terms. Sorry, it's hard. But yeah, something like that would be pretty cool, I think.
Barry, can you pronounce this guy's name for me again? Branus?
Akela Branus.
Mr. Branus, do you have a changing room that I could utilize for a moment?
He motions over to his right, to your left, and there's a door that says changing room.
Okay, I'm going to go over there and change into these new clothes out of this combat jumpsuit.
All right.
Yeah, I think my character would like that. How much is this, this outfit?
If you examine it, you notice there's a sticker hanging from the sleeve that says 70.
70 credits? Just 70 credits?
Yep.
Nice. He goes over. It's like,
this is a really nice outfit. I'd like to purchase this.
Do I need to speak louder?
That'll be 70 credits.
Ah, sure thing.
He hands him 70 credits. Hold on, let me change my profile thing and remove 70 out of it. Okay, there we go. You guys still there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sorry, were you guys able to hear me? I said, he purchases the outfit. I took out 70 credits from my, my wallet.
Yep. Got that.
Okay, I come back out of the changing room in my new clothes with my combat jumpsuit folded up. And, I hand it to the shopkeeper and ask him if he's interested in purchasing it.
Well, I can purchase it, yeah, no problem. Let me see here. Alright, it's not that bad, not that bad. Got a little bit of a few scuff marks. I can see you used it at least a few times. I'll go ahead and give you 1430 for it.
I may consider that offer. However, I want to ask you in the meantime, what are the costs of these items that I'm planning to purchase from you?
Ah, 30 credits.
Roleplay-wise, my character's still waiting for him to, I guess my character has been holding the outfit when he gave him the credits. Because I thought he was going to hand it to him after he paid or something like that.
No, you pulled it off the rack. It's literally in your hands on a hanger. You just have to pay him for it.
Yeah, he did pay him.
Oh, okay. In that case, it's in your hand. Just give the hanger back.
Yeah, I give him. He gives him back the hanger. And he goes into the changing room.
I don't know, if it's like Walmart, then you probably keep the hanger.
I guess it depends if he remembers to give it back. It's just a wire hanger anyway.
It's probably a hanger that's plastic and says Made in China right on it.
Okay. What are you talking about? It says Made in Hutta.
Good one.
I think I'm willing to accept 1430 for the jumpsuit if you'll throw in this outfit for free.
All right. Give me a persuasion roll. I will consider that. Let's see what
we got. Come on, dice. Yeah.
He looks at you and goes, yeah, I'll take that. That's a good deal.
Very good. Thank you.
Well, thank you. It was a pleasure doing business with you.
Out of context, I'm currently drawing the design for his new outfit as we speak.
Oh, very cool.
Yeah, I'm hoping to be able to take a picture of it eventually when it's ready.
So, Gakaresh, did you buy a comlink?
Oh, he's in the changing room.
Knock, knock, knock. Gakaresh, did you buy a comlink?
Yeah, the changing room is just a curtain with a closet.
I'm thinking of like the ones with the doors on it, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, this ain't that fancy.
Yeah, no, this is basically Walmart. There's a curtain there.
Not at my Walmart.
A modesty wall in front of the curtain, but...
Ah.
Yeah, it's just a curtain.
Alrighty. He's a little nervous because he doesn't want you to come in because he's currently changing right now.
Why would I come in? I'm not going to come in.
He's just shouting from... or not really even shouting, just saying from the counter, did you buy a comlink? You can hear him clearly.
Alrighty.
Yeah, working on it.
Akela smiles as he waits for you.
Do I have to be trained in treat injury, or trained in that to use med packs?
I believe so.
So if I don't have train injury and we get injured, we're just out of luck. Like, we have second wind and that's it.
I mean, I'm going to double check, but knowing this rule system, probably.
No, you don't need to be trained in treat injury to use a med pack. It specifically says it's designed to be used in the field to allow untrained individuals to apply first aid in emergencies.
Alright, well, then there you go.
Have you guys ever used the portable computer equipment in this game? And what is that used for? Can it do anything that a datapad can't do?
The portable computer. What page is that on?
It's on 136.
Gives you a higher bonus to, like, computer skill checks, or, like, when you're trying to hack something, that sort of stuff.
Okay, is that a house rule, or is that actually in the rules? Because there's like one paragraph here. Where?
I gotta go look it up, but it's because it's got a higher will.
Mm-hmm.
It says the portable computer has an intelligence 14.
Oh, intelligence, there we go.
It's on page 136. I'm just curious. While
So an intelligence 14 gives a stat modifier of +2. I believe, and the data pad gives a stat modifier of +1.
Correct.
Okay, so it gives you one an additional +1 for use computer. Okay.
When you use it.
Right, over the data pad. Overall, it gives you a +2 when you use computers in conjunction with this.
So, how's it coming, Kakarash? You almost dressed?
He pops right out the dressing room, and you see him in this red, elaborate red robe with some, like, golden trimming, and the kind of hangs out in the front, kind of like the picture I just showed out of context. Something like that.
Good to go.
Are you good to go? Do you have everything you need?
Scratches his head.
Yeah, right. Do you have any comments, Surrender?
As you say that, you look down, and he's got, like, 5 or 6 different kinds of comlinks down in front of him. Various qualities and whatnot, just kind of waiting there. It seems like he had pulled them out while he was waiting for you.
Yeah, he's in the middle of his sentence. Oh, never mind. Goes over and looks at him.
Yeah, he's got them priced from, like, lows to highest, and as you can tell, there are some that are really small. They seem to be more short range, and then there are others that are a little bit bulkier, and they seem more to be long range communications.
Kakarash, if I were you, I'd recommend just for right now buying a small short range comlink.
I'm sorry, I was out of context. I'm sorry, I didn't hear that. Hold on, let me adjust my volume. Oh, I'm at max. Alright.
I said I would recommend for right now just buying a small, basic, inexpensive short range comlink.
Alright.
Alright then, in that case, may I recommend this, a Corellian Special. It is the T-61 comlink device. It will cover all your needs for all short-range communications.
He looks it over and then he taps Walt on the shoulder, kind of hinting to talk to him privately.
Can you excuse us a moment, please?
Of course, of course.
Okay, we take a few steps away from the counter. I say, what is it?
Look, we're probably going to need a higher range than this. If we get split up, we're done for if we don't have any communique. We're probably going to have to spend a little more. Just to be sure, just in case, for the quality.
How much money you got?
Yeah, looks through it.
370.
This is the nicest comlink that you can afford right now.
He sighs heavily.
Alright then, fine.
You are prompted to head back to the counter.
Oh, well, you know what? Actually, I'm sorry. I was mistaken. You can buy a long-range comlink, but it's not like a little handheld thing. It's a backpack.
Oh, all right. Okay, so I guess we kind of start back at him, telling we probably need a better quality communique system. What's your character's response now?
A better communique system than the Corellian T-75?
I thought we were still in the private conversation.
Oh, okay. I'm trying to figure that out, too.
You just said we walk back over to the counter.
Yeah, I said let's restart the conversation. Sorry about that. I guess I just gotta be lucky. Never mind.
Okay. Look, the short range comlinks are little handheld devices, and they have a range of 50 kilometers. And they cost 25 credits. They're really affordable. Long range ones can go 200 kilometers, but they cost 10 times as much. They're 250 credits, and they're the size of a backpack. They're not handheld. Now, you can upgrade those so that they're like a wrist size thing, but it doubles the price. So that would be 500 credits.
I still think we need this.
You don't have enough money for that.
Got 370.
You realize that 50 kilometers is 31 miles, right?
I really, really don't think we're going to get that far apart from one another.
Pray not. Alright, fine.
I want to ask the guy behind the counter. Listen, what did you say this was? This is a Corellian T-65 comlink?
T-75.
I beg your pardon, T-75. Can this particular model be upgraded in the future to a long-range unit with a miniaturized wrist set?
He looks down and then kind of looks over. Possibly.
Well, do you have any short-range comlinks that can be upgraded that way?
For that, that's technically an aftermarket modification, but yeah, it can be done.
Alright, well, give us the short-range comlink for right now, and maybe if we feel like we need the upgrades, we'll come by later.
Alright, no problem. And he slides over the T-75, nice little package, and 25 credits.
That's, of course, including a 10% discount.
Oh, yes, I completely forgot about that. Sorry. Sorry about that. 22 credits and 22 and a half credits, please.
Are we rounding up or rounding down? Because we don't have half credits on this, do we?
We'll go ahead and round down this time. 22 credits.
Would you accept 20?
Sure.
Pay the man, Gagaresh.
Sorry, I was working on the outfit. I mean, out of context, sorry.
You owe the man 20 credits.
Oh, alright, yeah, I forgot about my own comlink. Alright, he hands him over 20 credits.
Here you go.
Oh, thank you.
Not at all. Good doing business with you.
A pleasure. Do consider me when you come, when you wish to upgrade that.
Will do. Thank you.
Can you think of anything else that you'll need before for this mission, Shagrash?
He pauses for a moment to kind of think it over. He looks along the walls. So this is kind of like a Walmart in Star Wars. Okay, so he sees blasters, I would assume. Any guns or anything that we can use?
Yeah, there's on the other side of the clothes, there's a full list. It's almost behind the counter, though, of various kinds of blasters. All varying kinds and whatnot, Star Wars-y style, but functionally speaking, there's blaster pistols, heavy blaster pistols, blaster rifles, blaster carbines, and whatnot.
As I recall, during the last mission, Gatgrass, you captured two blaster pistols from the enemies that we were fighting.
Yeah, but we might need an upgrade.
Kind of looks over the walls and sees the blaster rifles, which kind of looks rather interesting to him and kind of wants to talk it out with you.
Pull up the rifle section as soon as I find it.
You can't use a rifle without a penalty.
There's that as well.
So you're not my character, but from Walt.
I don't have rifle proficiency either.
Okay. Alright, we'll just pretend that didn't happen.
Speaking of which, Barry, that reminds me, I've also got 3 captured blaster pistols and 6 power packs I'd like to sell.
All right.
They're just the standard. I think that they were just standard blaster pistols.
Yeah, the 3D6 one.
Alright, yeah, I finally got the outfit, so I'm gonna try and color it up and then take a picture of it when I'm done.
Alright, go ahead and give me a persuasion roll, see how much you get from these used blasters.
Okay. Can I use a force point?
Of course.
If you want, yeah.
What are you selling? Blaster pistols?
We captured them from the. Remember the guys that we kept disarming and getting to surrender in the.
Yeah,
the quads gang hideout.
Yep, I know what you're talking about.
Adventures in toilet clogging.
Hard to forget.
Part 2 of the Wrath of Khan.
He examines each one as you lay them down, and just you can tell he's pondering and whatnot. All right, I could part with about, oh, say about 470 per blaster. These look to be really good, and we can get them up and running for our purposes.
Yeah, I'll accept 470 each. What about for these 6 power packs?
If they're at full charge, he'll just pay market price for them.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
Ah, no problem, no problem.
Sorry if I'm not talking enough. I'm still working on his outfit.
You're fine. Talk as much as you want.
Great, yeah, I think this suit will be pretty epic. Or not suit, but just the outfit.
Okay, the way I figure it, the take on those blasters and power packs comes out to 1,560 credits. And when I split that four ways, it comes to 390. So I wanted to give 390 credits kind of as pay for the last job to the other three members of my team.
I'm sorry, something got just distracted me. Could you say that one more time?
I added all the money that I just made selling those blasters and the power packs, and I wanted to give a share of it to the other three members of my team.
Okay.
It comes out to 1560 total, but split four ways, that's 390. So I wanted to keep 390 for myself and give 390 to Gak and I don't even know the other.
Oh yeah, and
yeah, there you go.
390. Okay, I'll put that in their sheets.
Okay. Gamer, you can add 390 credits to your available credit pool.
Oh, nice. Thanks, man. Oh, wait, hold on, in game.
Oh, thank you.
$390, right?
I'm giving you that money with the hope and trust that you're done pulling turrets off walls randomly.
Alright, sorry, I'm just doing that to add it. Alright, he now has 1,120 credits. And I'm still working on his outfit.
Okay, well, did you want to go to any other stores still?
No, other than clothes and what I've learned about armor today. I think we're good now.
Okay, I don't want to try this with a negative one on my condition track, so I want to rest before we go try to do this.
Yeah, good idea. My character's been a little tired. What time is it? I'm assuming it's nighttime.
It's more like 2 a.m. or 2 p.m.
Oh, 2 p.m. Oh, wow. Night.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's definitely gonna need rest.
But you guys can, if there's other things you would like to accomplish before the mission.
Oh, 2 p.m. Sorry, I was getting mixed up with 2 a.m. My bad.
You can feel free to do that. And then, there are rooms available here, if you'd like to look for them. But if there's nothing else you want to accomplish today, then we'll just skip to that.
I'm consulting my notes. Did we talk about when would be a good time to try to go make contact with these cultists?
Well, what they told you was the location of the temple that these cultists are meeting in, and that periodically throughout the day, their leader will come out and she'll give speeches in the streets. It's during the daytime hours. At around about 6 o'clock, then they tend to disappear, presumably going back to where they live. So if you're wanting to see one of those speeches or make contact with them, that's probably the best time.
Okay, so we could just go to the temple and listen to the speech that they make, and then are there cultists inside the temple also?
Well, you didn't ask about that specifically, but you get the impression there's always people at the temple. It's just that their leader isn't there during the days until after about 6. But before then, she's not at the temple. She's in the streets preaching and prophesizing her whatever.
Okay, so it's 2 p.m. right now. What do I need to do to move up the condition track? Do I need to get 8 hours?
Yeah.
Okay, then that's what I want to do.
Do you want to go to sleep now, or do you want to wait till later?
No, I want to go to sleep now, because... Okay. I was thinking about going there tonight when I wake up and seeing if there's any activity late at night.
Okay, that's easily done. So do you want to talk to someone about it, or about rooms, or do you want me to just kind of summarize?
I'll just suggest that to Gek. What do you think about getting some sleep and then getting up later tonight and going and checking out this temple?
Yeah, I'm pretty wiped.
Alright, I'll wake you up in 8 hours. And then I'm gonna go look for rooms for us.
Alright, good.
All right. So, if you go and find Nell again, she will direct you to some rooms. She'll tell you that there is that some were prepared for you beforehand, kind of thinking ahead. She's willing to forego charging you for them and including it as part of your compensation.
Okay.
So,
why? So. What's that? Oh.
So, yeah, you guys, between the four of you, there are two rooms that you can split up in any way you'd like.
Okay, I'm gonna go in a room and... Oh, shoot. I was gonna buy med packs. Can we just retcon and say I did that too? About two of them?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, how much are they?
Med packs?
100 a pop with your 10% discount, 90 a pop.
Okay. How about two?
Okay.
All right. You guys spend a surprisingly restful evening, as these rooms are well furnished and seem to be well insulated, in that you don't hear the outside music or the beating or any of that stuff, which is kind of odd considering the time of night. But eventually, after 8 hours, you guys come to, and Let's see, this would be about 10 o'clock at night. So, as you come out of your rooms, you do find that the bar is a lot more lively. There's a lot more people there as you leave.
Was that part of the role play?
Yeah.
Really? Sounded like someone was knocking on your door or something.
Oh, that yeah. Probably was not.
No, I gotta go to take care of something. So Barry will take charge now.
All right.
Yeah, with it being like 10 o'clock at night at this bar, the scene is hopping, as it were, as the kids would say.
These beets are so fresh. Snap.
Yeah, I don't think we talk exactly like that, but...
I'm not. I'm just being silly right now. Okay.
Men's on the attempt, though.
So I rouse Gak and I say, let's go check out this temple and see what we can see.
Yeah, all right.
And I want to go wake up. Are the other two are here? Can we bring them along? Are you going to do them for us?
Yeah.
Okay, I want to go wake them up too, and bring them with us as well.
All right. Dart stirs and slowly gets out of bed. All right, and Koya hops out. After yawning quite a bit, though, and she agrees and comes with you.
Okay, so we know exactly how to get to this temple. Do we need to ask for directions, or do we know right where we're going?
No, they give you directions as to where it is.
Okay, is it within walking distance? Can we walk there in like less than a half hour, or do we need to get a car?
For this distance, you would have to get a car. It's towards the outer edge of the city. So I'm assuming y'all flag down a car, which at this time of night in front of the Twice Morning Star, yeah, transportation should be easy to find.
Actually, I was gonna try to ask Evren and Elle if maybe they have a car that could drop us off.
It would depend on who you ask.
Okay, well, I'm a little bit I'm a little bit confused about precisely who's in charge of that operation. Who's the boss of that?
Of the whole operation is, as far as you can tell, it's Evren, but you can tell that Nell has some say, at least.
Is it L or Nell?
Nell. Ellie
Nell.
Is...
November?
Yeah. November, the Chiss lady is the one at the bar. Ellie, the one I noted in the chat log, is the Azler who was very hyper and whatnot and ran towards the eggs and whatnot last session.
Chat? Where?
In the chat log.
Oh, yeah, okay, I see. Okay.
Oh, that yellow freak, I'm getting now.
Oh, that yellow freak, oh, man, you better hope she doesn't hear you say that.
Alright, I'm gonna take just a moment to go bug her and see if she doesn't have a driver that can take us and deliver us there.
Alright. Go ahead and give me a persuasion roll, then.
Man!
When you do flag her down, you can tell since she's working the bar area, she's really busy, and when you do end up eventually flag her down, it's kind of a situation of she kind of responds and goes, "I'm a little busy now." And when you finally do pin her down and ask her, she's like, "I don't know if we have anyone available right now."
Alright, fine. I'll make two. At least I got that out of the way with minimal negative consequences. Okay, yeah, I guess I go out to the curb and try to flag down a taxi for the four of us.
Yeah, one just literally is waiting right there at the curb for you, though. This time of night, people are coming and going to the Twice More Star in like droves, so there's readily available a taxi no matter what happens.
Okay, I give him the address for a location one block away from where we're actually going.
That's so weird.
I just realized something. How is Jack gonna fit in?
These are taxis.
Yeah, it's like that 9 feet tall, I think.
We got a big taxi that's especially for big people.
Yeah, it's easy to find a van-style taxi, as it were. Plenty of headroom. This is busy time of the night, so there's an abundance of vehicles right here.
Funny how everything just magically comes together in some points and others not so much.
Well, right here, yeah, because it's 10 o'clock at night. I mean, that's a really good time to go to a bar or whatnot. People are getting off of work. They're hanging out with their friends and then going bar hopping. And, of course, the Twice More Star is the place to be, of course.
Oh, yeah, man. Oh,
dude, of course, man.
Dude, man, that is like, you know, like, so awesome, man.
But yeah, this particular time of night is actually a really good time to get taxis going anywhere, so, okay.
Let's go!
Alright, he tells y'all to buckle up.
I have trouble buckling my belt, I'm kidding. Okay, he's not that stupid. He puts it together.
Okay, just for that one, Gakarush, give me a pilot roll. I want to see what your luck is on this.
Okay. Oh, that's hilarious. Okay, hold on.
Let's see what your luck is in getting this particular driver. Okay, not bad. You guys get there relatively quickly. A little faster than you probably would have wanted to, but not bad, in other words. In terms of speed and whatnot, he was probably going the equivalent of what would be like 30 miles above the speed limit, but hitting the turns just right to make it comfortable. So he's a good pilot, but a little fast.
Wait, who, me?
No, the pilot who's, or the driver of the taxi.
Oh, well, why would I roll it?
Because I'm using it as a luck roll.
Oh, okay.
If you'd rolled
to
low,
see if you could put on your seatbelt.
Yeah, that too.
Oh.
Alright, and then y'all get to this kind of an old, a very old temple. Or you're a block away from this old temple. You can see it in the distance, but it's there. Kind of old, and in the night, you can see the outlines of the stars as it illuminates the buildings and such. And then we will take a 10-minute break now, because I've noticed
that is,
we're missing some people.
That is a black square of the temple.
It's the line of sight. We can't see. We're just looking at the wall of the thing.
I know. I'm just messing with you guys.
I think I can see inside of a window, though. Okay, I'll be back in a second.
All right.
Alrighty.
Yep, take 10 minutes. We'll be back in 10.
All right, then.